Joining us right now is the U.S. Attorney for the state of Maryland. Glad to have him on board, Erek Barron. Good morning, U.S. Attorney.
Morning, sir.
Good morning, gentlemen. Good to be with you.
Look, reaching out to you because the couple of cases, we just shared one about Tyreek Braxton, a.k.a. Sun Sun, 28 of Baltimore, who was sentenced 25 years in federal prison. And there are other cases, U.S. Attorney, that highlight the fact that in addition with what State's Attorney Ivan Bates is doing with his step up in prosecution, in addition to Baltimore City Police Department doing more charging of folks with violent crime, your office is like another backstop to go after people carrying guns.
No, absolutely. When I came into office, we made it a point to sit down with our law enforcement partners, specifically the ATF, BPD, and the state's attorney's office, and we're screening every case. We're looking at each and every gun case for federal adoption and going beyond that. And, anyone who comes up on our radar as a driver of violence in our communities, we're looking to hold them accountable and take them off the streets. There's no question about it.
From the macro picture, I think we had you on last in May. We're now, almost at the end of the summer and halfway through the year of 2024. Is the trend continuing in the right direction? What have you seen in the last couple of months in which, especially in the summertime, which is usually a higher month for crime or at least violent crime?
I think the trend is continuing. We had, kind of a bit of a blip a month or two ago. But, knock on wood, things are continuing. Things are trending well. There's a lot more we need to be doing, but we're looking to finish the year very strong. We're working all together.
U.S. Attorney Erek Barron, I know that your office, we've talked about before, doesn't deal up with juvenile crime because that's something more on a local level. Having said that, though, your office did kind of want to step up when it came to carjackings, which, by the way, a lot of juveniles are involved with that. But we still have stubbornly seen an issue with people using weapons to carjack individuals. Where's that stand right now, U.S. Attorney?
Sure. So from an investigative standpoint, we're always and continue to be actively involved in, tracking down, robberies, carjackings, and whoever the perpetrators may be, including juveniles. Now, it just, there's just more of a challenge when it comes to bringing a case in the federal system with respect to juveniles. But we are on the ground with our state and local law enforcement partners, making sure that, we can track down whoever the perpetrators are, including juveniles. And so, we are actively involved in those cases. We just might not bring them in the federal court system.
Do you think that the people who you've put in jail, especially in the last year, are responsible for more crimes than you don't even know about? Basically, what I'm getting at is there's a belief that, hey, we're putting bad guys behind bars, and therefore this is helping to drive down the shootings and the murders because the people who are in jail have committed these crimes and maybe the crimes that we don't even know about.
Well, my theory of the case, so to speak, is that if we are focusing on repeat violent offenders and those whom we have the intelligence on to say that, these individuals are doing violence, they're part of violent gangs, and we catch these individuals with a gun, then that is probably an individual more likely than others to commit crimes in the future. So if we take that gun case or whatever the matter is, seriously, then, hold that individual accountable to the point where they are looking at jail time, then that's someone who, may likely have committed a crime in the future, which we've now prevented by holding that person accountable for what they've done here and now.
U.S. Attorney
that
Erek Barron.
It does.
Absolutely. Absolutely makes sense. U.S. Attorney Erek Barron, we talked with you in the past about this, and really even with your predecessor, Robert Herr, about Project Safe Neighborhoods, PSN is the acronym of that. But that kind of being at the federal level, the centerpiece of going after a lot of violent criminals, and even some of the cases we mentioned here. Just for a minute, remind us again, the Project Safe Neighborhoods is an initiative that brings all of these entities together to go after violent criminals.
Yes, that's the office's signature violent crime reduction initiative, and the overarching concept of it is having all of us working together, local, state, federal law enforcement, in a coordinated, team-oriented way, such that we have a strike force that's literally co-located. Everybody's in the same room, reviewing cases, working investigations together, and when we've wrapped a matter up in a bow, and we decide, okay, is this more appropriate for the state's attorney's office to take, or is this something that we should adopt and take federal? It's very low, very coordinated. You many times wouldn't even know, well, who's the federal prosecutor versus the state prosecutor. It's that close and coordinated, and that yields results.
So you are the U.S. Attorney of Maryland, and it's more than just Baltimore. Now, obviously, we focus on a lot more in Baltimore here these days, the last couple of years. But crime has been a problematic in the D.C. suburbs as well, though the numbers are down this year there as well. What can you tell us about what is going on, the trend across the entire state of Maryland? Are there other hotspots that you are concerned about? And what kinds of crimes are you seeing and that kind of gets your attention?
So it's down across Maryland, and Maryland is beating the national trend downward. In Prince George's, and then as you mentioned in the D.C. Border, that tends to be a very hot spot, so to speak. But what we do is similar to what we're doing here in the city, working very, very closely with Chief Aziz, who's the chief of the Prince George's County Police Department and the Montgomery County Police, and making sure that, we're coordinated, we're screening all the cases, the violent crime cases that we can, and we take the ones that we can make a bigger impact on at the federal level. And we just work to send the message to the community that, whatever you're doing elsewhere, you're definitely not going to get away with it in our state.
U.S. Attorney Erek Barron, finally from me, when it comes, Maryland U.S. Attorney, when it comes to what started under Governor Hogan, and I believe also has continued under Governor Westmore, that is providing your office with additional attorneys, funding for additional attorneys, because, of course, your staff is much more limited than some of these state's attorney's office. How is that still proceeding? Are you still getting the type of support for additional attorneys to help take these cases on?
We are still getting that support, thanks to Governor Moore. Governor Moore has continued the unprecedented level of funding that Governor Hogan started. It works. It really allows us to stretch our resources as an office and allows us to do more of those cases and do it even more in a coordinated way. Those special prosecutors and special investigators are experienced, many of whom are experienced individuals. They've worked at the state level, they've worked at the local level. And so we build that synergy, one, between our offices, but then also we have more bodies, we can investigate and take more cases.
Final question for me, and it's related to carjackings. And I know earlier in the year you were talking about how you're going to try to get this at the federal level where you could, which seems kind of strange. I'm wondering how that is going so far, and what you are seeing when it comes to car thefts and carjackings, and what your office, the U.S. Attorney's Office, is trying to accomplish in that realm?
So I think things have definitely improved. We just got to keep working at it. And, you know, wherever we have examples where we can take a case that, so for me, it's important for us to be able to not just send a message to an individual or individuals in one particular case, but take a case that can then send a message of general deterrence to, you know, to the broader community and those who are, you know, maybe involved in that, in some of that stuff, that it's not worth it. I'm trying to raise the risk level, so to speak, of doing this kind of stuff and terrorizing communities in this way, such that, you know, others get the message that, you know, maybe I need to move on to other things.
Well, U.S. Attorney Erek Barron, the evidence is in, and so far, at least 2024 is showing as dramatic a reduction as 2023, particularly in homicides and non-fatal shootings. Thank you so much for your time. We'll talk to you soon.
Always good to have you on.